quarterfinals completed. Next on court, more home interest because it's Xing Aiying up against the Hong Kong player Yip Pui Yin. The two players. Yip Pui Yin making her sixth appearance here at the Singapore Open. And in the first round, defeating Maria Phoebe Kasumasuti of Indonesia in two straight games. And then Laran of France in the second round. An hour and 6 minutes on court for those two matches. Xing Aiying beating her fellow teammate yesterday to set up this quarterfinal for Xing Aiying, making her 10th appearance here. Just started playing this event in 2003 when she was a 13-year-old, played in the women's doubles. So this is the fifth meeting between these two players. Last time they met was in the last 16 of Macau, and Yip Pui Yin won in three games on that occasion. Xing Aiying, the 22-year-old, born in Jiangsu province in mainland China, twice a quarter finalist here previously, back in 2004, when she was 14 years of age, but hasn't had the best of time of late. World ranking now at 49. Not seeded, of course. And Yip Pui Yin down three places in the world ranking to 26. And has been as high as 8. And when a player's been as high as 8, it's rather alarming to see a negative win-loss record for the year. This is her first quarter final of 2012. So Xing Aiying, two career titles. Won the US Open when she was 15 years and 54 days old. Extraordinary 15-year-old winning a major title at the US Open. Grand Prix events, of course, 49 in the world ranking. And she too has a negative win-loss record for the year, but she has been in a semi-final earlier this year. That was the Malaysian Grand Prix gold event. So this is her third quarter-final of the year. As for Yip Pui Yin, her first. And so the lady from Hong Kong, born in Sha Tin in Hong Kong,
ladies and gentlemen, on my left, Yip Pui Yin, Hong Kong tennis. And on my right, Xing Aiying, Singapore. Xing Aiying is the first love ball play.
Irianto from Indonesia, our umpire. Kang Shin Jun of Korea, the service judge.
Set is over. One love.
Now she'll certainly have the psychological advantage of Yip Pui Yin, having won three of the last four encounters. No doubt he's going to have more support. Four times in her career, she's beaten the number one player in the world. Two victories over Wang Yihan, who's the current world number one. They were both back in 2010. And also beats Zhang Ning, who's the current Olympic champion in the quarterfinal of the 2006 Asian Games. Beats Xu Jinping in the All England first round. Back in 2008, when she was the three-time defending All England champion, so no doubt Yip Pui Yin has had the big results and can beat the very best in the world. Hasn't really managed to translate that into tournament victories, hasn't been able to keep that going throughout the entirety of the tournament. Broken strings as she slashed that one. Career titles for the lady from Hong Kong. Chinese Taipei satellite event in 2005. Gold at the East Asian Games, which took place in 2009 in her home country. And the Malaysian Grand Prix gold 2 years ago. Individuals. Qualified for the Olympic Games. Third ranked Singapore women's singles player. It's Hu Yuan, who will represent Singapore at next month's Olympic Games. She doesn't think so. I have to say, it was mighty close. Yeah. Yip Pui Yin. An 8-point advantage to this lady, Xing Aiying. Good to see her back in good form. Yip Pui Yin, in contrast to her opponent, has qualified for the Olympic Games. Qualified ranked 23, but as the top ranked player from Hong Kong, qualifies under the BWF qualification rules. Good rally, it's landed well in. The realization and the despair that she's left it. She's pushed it wide and long. Shot to the last moment, swayed the body one way, hit the shuttle the other. Great deception. Get the shuttle back. That was the one. And now a 9-point advantage. Make that 10 points. Yip Pui Yin just appears at the moment to have lost purpose. Just reacting to whatever her opponent is throwing at her. Not really playing to any set tactics. Oh, that's wild. Twice a medalist in Asian Games, of course, Yip Pui Yin. Silver medal in 2006 in Doha. Bronze medal in 2010 in Guangzhou. Error on the drop shot. And game points aplenty for Xing Aiying. Shot. No. Yes. Seemed a little at sea in this opening game. Yip Pui Yin. Driving back the defensive shots. 21-9, the opening game to the home player, Xing Aiying. Yeah, the little clenched fist. Delighted with that opening game. 21-9, the scoreline. And just 14 minutes of play. Still getting advice from my coaches. Xing Aiying would have thought the number one piece of advice was just keep doing what you've been doing. Looked very much in control in that opening game. Oh, I'd love to know what her coaches have said to her.
Second
game, love on, play. Oh, my. goodness. Well, the kill off the top of the tape from Xing Aiying, absolutely superb. And then Yip Pui Yin did a full pirouette and still hit the shuttle, but hit it wide. Oh, it's called good. Immediately a little appeal from Yip Pui Yin to the umpire, asking whether her opponent had touched the shuttle before it went over the net. No, she hadn't. That in the opening game. That's what you know she can do. The key is moving to the shuttle, taking it as early as possible. Right knee. Knees always take a battering in badminton. Yeah, that's nice. My goodness me. Hasn't she upped the pace? Not pace of shot, but pace of movement. Moving much, much quicker. Yip Pui Yin. Of the body slash. And we just couldn't get her body out of the way and give herself the freedom to play the shot. Yip Pui Yin. pushed it wide. And Xing Aiying back level. Few women singles players who regularly uses the jump smash, as indeed she did in that last rally. Yes, it really is the key to everything, taking the shuttle early. She comes from above the shuttle, and therefore the simple block, but she's got the options. Instead of addressing the shuttle with the racket coming from below the shuttle, comes from above it. She can attack, she can block, she can lift. Oh, she looks a totally different player now in the second game, doesn't she? Outclassed in the first, Yip Pui Yin. And now a 3-point cushion here in the second. Forehand corner, goes back to base position, then deep to the round the head position, and finds the line. Watches it drop long. On a run of 5 straight points. Goes to the mid-game interval with a 5-point advantage. And of course this quarter-final battle for the right to play against the number 4 seed, Chen Xiaoqie of Taipei. Chen Xiaoqie having beaten Sayaka Sato of Japan, the number 7 seed, in their quarter-final battle. Get that back. Now, yeah, well, it was worth the extra effort, wasn't it? Super Series semi-final, Xing Aiying. This is her third quarter-final. but never progressed beyond this stage. Not yet, anyway. The shuttle changed. Xing Aiying said no. Umpire had a look at the shuttle and he agreed with Xing Aiying. Oh, serve's gone wide of that centre line. What a wasted opportunity. There's the slice, and then the power play, and played to absolute perfection. Of the body smash, much flatter. And Xing Aiying, I think, just totally surprised by the angle. It's going to go wide. 6-point advantage now to Yip Pui Yin. You get out of brilliance from Yip Pui Yin. Next moment, something a little wild. And there's the moment of brilliance. Super smash. The top of the net didn't go over, and we're creeping ever closer to a third and deciding game. Nicely done. Well, just seems to be seeing the shuttle so much earlier in this second game. And it's got this lady on the back foot. Three points away from the third and deciding game. Certainly after what we've seen earlier today, Xing Aiying definitely should not give up on this second game. And once again, a little discrepancy between the two players as to whether the shuttle should be changed or not. Point deficit has been halved. Well, I think Yip Pui Yin took a shot on her forehand side there, which she needed to play. I think it was going wide. This one chose to play it. Just 2 points in it. There's the jump smash. Very athletic player. Is it Queen? That's nice. Oh, it's gone long. Good fighting spirit from Xing Aiying. My goodness, she was under pressure in that rally. Last 7 points have gone in favour of Xing Aiying. My goodness, this is a crucial rally. And the clear has gone long. 19 all. That's 7 of 8 rallies in favour of the Singapore player. Oh, good defence. Oh, yes. Kept her nerve. And so now, a game point opportunity for the Hong Kong player to level this quarter final at one game apiece. Good flick serve. Oh, I don't believe it. Two dives in that rally from Yip Pui Yin. Kept the rally alive. Look at that. And again. What drama, what excitement. To adjust the headband after this rally. Look, yep, just pushes back the headband. 20 all. Extra points required until there's a clear 2-point winning margin. Well, would you believe it? Having just saved a game point, now Xing Aiying has a match point herself. Well, no overrule from the umpire, I have to say. But I don't think we'll see it from this angle because it was the sideline that was in question. I have to say, I have some sympathy for Xing Aiying. No, we can't tell from that. Well, she was convinced. And I have to say, so was I. That's no overall from the umpire means that it's 21 all. Good return of serve. Second match point opportunity for Xing Aiying. Singapore. having survived a game point, the 22-year-old Singaporean clinches victory in 41 minutes. Well, there was that doubt on the line call on her first match point opportunity. There was no doubt whatsoever on the second match point. It was clearly wide. And their confirmation that she threw her first ever Super Series semi-final. 21-9, 23-21. Disappointments for Singapore in the women's doubles, but delight here in the women's singles. Excitement all evening here at the Singapore Indoor Stadium.